goes. That summer music turned up loud. Go Country 105.
Country 105. That was Keith Urban and Bookie. You just saw something online. That sounds
pretty
cool.
It's pretty cool. So Walmart is going to be transforming 160 of its store parking lots into drive-in theaters.
That is insane.
That is kind of cool. Right? I know. I mean, that is a great idea. They say they're going to do it starting in early August, and they're just going to be pop-ups at different locations throughout the country. They haven't named any locations yet, but you can follow them online. They say you can sign up at Walmart.com for, you know, updates as to where these locations are going to be in the movie.
That's
wild,
too. I wonder how big. I mean, I guess the Walmart parking lots are huge.
They usually are really big parking lots. I mean, you know, I'm thinking about the one in Burbank, and, I mean, that is a huge area, and it's so easy for them to do that and just, you know, convert that space and have a drive-in theater. And this is something I've really been wanting to do, is go to, like, a drive-in theater and watch a movie.
Cool. I'm just wondering, though, because Walmart always seems to be packed. Like right now, so I'm wondering like how that's actually going to affect the store traffic.
Well, it'll be a, well, I'm sure later. Well, yeah. Well, I mean,
because they're 24 hours too, aren't they?
Not all of them.
Oh, is
no, the one
in Burbank isn't.
I don't think there was one in Burbank. Oh yeah, yeah, there is one in Burbank. Yeah, right off the 5. Yeah, I don't think that one is, but yeah, not all of them are. But you know,
it'd be interesting to see anyway.
Well, think about it. You know, you go in, you get some snacks, and then go back to the car.
And you already have your seat in place.
Yeah.
You don't worry about losing your seat. Drive-in, I suppose they're not compromising parking.
Think of the store as one big concession stand.
That's
a
really good point, actually.
So they would probably end up making.
Think they're
going to
start selling cars for those that don't have them?
Oh, they could. Actually, that would be kind of cool. Actually, you know, if you think about it, all those rental cars that aren't being used, if people aren't going on vacation, have those there.
There you go.
You know, I guess somehow.
Be good marketing for the car dealerships.
Yeah, exactly.
People showcase their new vehicles.
Exactly, and people can sit there and watch the movie. And so I think it would be pretty cool to check out.
Have you been to one of those super huge like superstores like a Walmart but overseas in Europe?
No.
They do actually sell cars and like scooters
really?
In those stores. Yeah, it's really funny.
At the Walmart?
Yeah, it's not a Walmart, but they'll be different.
Oh, but they're equivalent.
Yeah.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, it's pretty wild over there. So maybe you never know.
Interesting.
You never know. You can get like your $10,000 scooter.
Costco has a whole car thing, buying thing. Yeah, I mean,
I
you can buy anything at Costco. I went yesterday. I was so excited.
I guess it's more like a Costco than a Walmart.
Yeah, you can get caskets to cars.
Can you buy music there?
At Costco?
Yeah.
Probably.
Probably.
You can buy books.
You could buy, like, Kenny Chesney's new album featuring his song called...
It's worth looking, Tim.
Here and Now.
You know
right
what?
Now,
the one that we're about to play right now, like this.
Go Country 105.
Like this. Here we go, Tim. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Kenny Chesney.
Do it.
Seen the skyline of New York City, fireflies in Tennessee, sipped a little shine from a paper sack that'll knock the horns off a Cadillac. I must have sat on a dozen islands, watched the sun sink into the sea, been there, done that, got the t-shirt and hat, but my favorite place to be is
Country 105.